It is a scorching afternoon as a determined motley crew in a pickup truck makes its way from the bustling city of Osogbo, the capital of the state of Osun in southwestern Nigeria, to the historic town of Ilesha, about 45 kilometers away. Across the state, similar trips are being made to all public senior secondary schools to introduce a device that was developed out of the extreme necessity to reverse decades of neglect of the state's educational infrastructure and core systems.
When we assumed office in November of 2010, the condition of the state was very, very bad. In all spheres, in education, it was terrible. In the environment, it was bad. Generally, the state of the state was not attractive at all. It was quite depressing.
A situation where only 3% of our students were matriculable, the school's performance at that level was just too horrible. We had to be radical. And one of the major things we did was to introduce technology and ICT to drive education at this level, at the high school level.
The result is Opon Imo, a standalone e-learning device that runs on an Android-based platform, providing each student and teacher three key elements for effective technology-driven learning.
I was at a mall in Docklands. And in the mall, while moving around, I didn't go there to buy anything actually. I just went for sightseeing, what you call window shopping. I got into a fairly big bookshop in the mall. And while moving around the bookshop, I saw this electronic reader. It's a tablet. It had about, he had some books, not many, probably 10 books on the e-reader. I'd seen e-readers before then, but at that instance, a friend of mine just looked at me and said, would it not be good if we adapt this for our children in schools? Clearly, the message sunk, and I began from that moment looking at how we could get digitized textbooks for our students.
Opon Imo is built on an Android operating system. It is subdivided into three major environments, namely the virtual learning environment, the e-library, and the test zone. The virtual learning environment is that environment that houses all of the lesson notes for 17 subjects as produced by our master teachers. The test center has 40,000 past questions and answers for the 17 subjects and for the past 10 years of German WAEC. The e-library has in it 56 textbooks for the 17 subjects we offer in the state electronically.
Hello students, good afternoon. Hello.
Opon Imo is one of the instructional materials of the highest order, because the simulation and everything is there for them. The student will see the picture, they will see the contents, the questions are there for them. So all what the teacher needs now is that get to the class, let them bring the thing out and start teaching.
The students were given their own tablets. I handled mine, and looking at this, it's as if we are bringing the whole class together, at least flipping through the screen. They are also handling their own. So if I want to at least teach them, I will refer them to the page I want them to go. So easily they can easily flip through the tablet themselves.
I feel excited about receiving the appointment because what I've been hearing about it, because they say it's good for us to study, and it will be the easiest means for students to study instead of wasting our energy going to the bookshop to get some books.
But this Opon Imo, it consists everything. Instead of us to be borrowing textbook, to be borrowing textbooks that they will even insult us before they give us. This we'll just bring out this Opon Imo and go straight to the subject that we want to.
When we were working on it, we had an understanding that there is a change in the curriculum. There's a new curriculum by the federal government, and we had to send somebody, the government sent somebody to Abuja, you know, to go and get the new curriculum, so that, you know, we had to start the work all over again in line with the new curriculum. So talking about the curriculum, as a matter of fact, the curriculum made up the content of the appointment.
Just the cost of purchasing 56 textbooks for each of the 150,000 pupils in our high school, that alone will require 8.4 billion naira. But it is a micro fraction of that we have spent on the digitized copies of the textbooks in Opon Imo.
Inu mi lu si Opon Imo yi tori pe kini o tun din wa ni owo ku gbo gbo pe ko ta ra mo pe a ma ra textbook ni si ko si anfa lati pe a fe ra textbook kankan mo won si ara la fa lati pe anytime to wa wu lo le mo ni a mo gbe lati mo ka.
The pupils in our public schools get Opon Imo free of charge. Those in private schools, because they have abandoned the public schools for private school, and they are ready and willing and capable of paying the fees of private schools, they have to pay for the device. So once there is the desire to acquire, as I've said, there will be appointment for them to buy.
Currently we're in the installation plan, as you can see behind me, and the installation process is currently ongoing. We have a quality assurance team here that tests every tablet to see that they meet the standard that is required by the Project Management Office. And after this, we move to the actual rollout. We'll be rolling out across the 9 federal constituencies in the state of Osun. And we intend to have support centers across these 9 federal constituencies, where each support center will be headed by a supervisor. We're going to have store managers. We have a school liaison team. We have the dispatch team and the training and the support team.
With the electricity situation in our country, we are providing in the schools communal solar charger that will ensure that whoever has the device, the tablet, can charge it through the communal solar charging pillars that will be installed in virtually all the schools where this device is supplied.
We are building 100 state-of-the-art schools. You could see the model. By the time the schools are ready, you will find that in the state of Osun, education is powerfully driven with technology. So we are confident that with what we have in place, our children will perform optimally.
I see a future where, through Opon Imo, performances of our students will have improved remarkably. I also see a future where Osun will be seen as a crucible of creative thoughts, a place where dreams of generation become reality. I see a future where we'll have narrowed the digital divide in Osun. A future where we'll have etched or erased completely the lines of technological iniquity. That's the future I see in Osun.
Please, my brothers and sisters worldwide, you are welcome to the state of Osun, where education has been democratized through the use of tablet of knowledge, which is affordable, easy to use, and ready for students who must be encouraged to have sound, functional, and quality education.